السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ولا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ما بعد. We started last week the biography of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, his name, his lineage, his tribe عليه الصلاة والسلام. And we mentioned that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the best home, from the best tribe, from the best place, alayhi salatu wa salam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows from where to choose His prophets and messengers, alayhi salatu wa salam. Allahu a'lamu, Allah says in the Quran, Allahu a'lamu haythu yaj'alu risalatah. Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala where to put his message. Yani, it means which prophet, which man should be chosen. Not the kuffar, because they accused the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They said, why the revelation did not come to one of these men? لولا أنزل هذا القرآن على رجل من القريتين عظيم. They were looking for a man in Ta'if and another man from another place or from Quraysh. Why specifically Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was a prophet? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. وَرَبُّكَ يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيَخْتَارُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who creates. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who chooses, subhanahu wa ta'ala, not us. Allah chooses this man to be an Arabic man, an non-Arabic, a black, white, red. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not us. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was one of the best. And even the kuffar, we mentioned this hadith, a very important hadith of Bukhari. Abu Sufyan, when he is a Muslim, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. But he became Muslim late. Yeah, before the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about in 4 years or 3 years. So when he was kafir, when he was non-Muslim, Hercules asked him about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is Muhammad, what is his name, and how many people follow him, or the number of people who are following him increasing or decreasing. What kind of people following him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, follow him? So one of the questions, who is Muhammad? What is the lineage? What is his tribe? Abu Sufyan, when he was kafir, he said, huwa fina du nasab. His family, his lineage is yani, an honorable lineage, alayhi salatu wassalam. Very high class lineage, alayhi salatu wassalam. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Sayyid Walad Adam, he is the leader of the children of Adam, alayhi salatu wassalam. And also we mentioned the names of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And so the nickname or kunya, what does mean kunya? Yani, for example, my son is Abdurrahman, so my kunya is Abu Abdurrahman. If your son is Abdullah, so your kunya is Abu Abdullah, like this. This is called kunya in Arabic. So what was the kunya of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Abu al-Qasim. Abu al-Qasim. Also, he is Abu Ibrahim because he had son Ibrahim. And also we mentioned Muhammad. And this name, how many times came the Quran? The name Muhammad. Four times. Okay? The name Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, came in the Quran four times. And also one of his names, Ahmed. How many times in the Quran? One time. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam said, Allah mentioned about Isa in the Quran, وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولِ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أحمد. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam gave a glad tiding that a prophet will come, or a messenger will come after me, his name is Ahmed. So he is Ahmed, and also he is Muhammad. Also Al-Mahi, one of his names alayhi salatu wasalam, Al-Mahi والعاقب والحاشر والمقفي ونبي الرحمة ونبي التوبة ونبي الملحمة وخاتم النبي وعبد الله. And we mentioned these names last week. And also we mentioned that the name of fathers of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad ibn Abdullah, ibn Abdul Muttalib, ibn Hashim, ibn Abd Manaf, ibn Qusay, ibn Kilab, ibn Murrah, ibn Ka'b, ibn Lu'ay, ibn Ghalib, ibn Fihr, ibn Malik, ibn Nadr, ibn Kinana, ibn Khuzaymah, ibn Mudrika, ibn Ilyas, ibn Mudar, ibn Nizar, ibn Ma'd, ibn Adnan. This is the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his fathers. Until Adnan. All the scholars agreed on this name, the fathers until Adnan. And what is higher than Adnan, okay, we don't, yani the scholars don't agree. And one of the fathers of Adnan is Ismail. And we are sure that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we mentioned this, came from Ismail or Ishaq? Ismail. Because Ibrahim is the father of prophets. And he has these two children, prophets, Ismail and Ishaq. Ibrahim, the father. Ishaq and Ismail. From Ismail, only there is one prophet. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And from Ishaq, there are plenty of prophets, alayhi salatu wa salam. Ishaq, his son, Ya'qub. And Ya'qub, his son, Yusuf. And they are Bani Israel. When we read about Bani Israel, Bani Israel, Israel is Ya'qub, alayhi salam. Okay, so when you read, Bani Israel means the children of Israel, the children of Jacob, alayhi salatu wa salam. And that's why, or this is one of the reasons why the Yahud, the Jews, did not believe in our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because they want the last prophet to be from the children of Ishaq. But this child came, or this messenger came from Ismail. So that's why they hate the Arabs and they hate the Muslims. They hate the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because they say the last messenger should be from Ya'qub, from Ishaq. Okay, the Muslim should not care that the prophet from the lineage of Ishaq or Ismail. If he is a prophet, khalas, we have to follow him. We have to believe in him. We as Muslims love all the prophets. If you remember what we said, okay, maybe the first lecture or second lectures, we said our belief, our faith, we should believe in all the prophets and we have to love all the prophets. This is one of the criteria of the Muslim nation. We have to love Ibrahim, Ismail, Ishaq, Ya'qub, Musa, wa Isa, wa Zakariya, wa Lut. All of them, our prophets. Alayhi salatu wa salam. All of them, our prophets. Aman al-Rasul bima unzil ilayhi min Rabbi wal-mu'minun. Kullun amana billahi wa kutubi wa rasulih. Okay, so all the believers believe in all the prophets. لا نفرق بين أحد منهم. We don't differentiate between the messengers. It means I love Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Also, I love Zakaria. I believe in Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and also I believe in Lut. I believe in Yahya. So as Muslims, we have to believe in all the prophets. But we have to follow the way of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, only Muhammad. Why? Because he is the last prophet and he came and to cancel all the messengers, I mean all the sharia, or all the laws before him, alayhi salatu wasalam. But we have to respect all of them. طيب, so our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم from the siblings of Ismail عليه الصلاة والسلام. طيب, what is the position of our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم among the Arabs? As we mentioned that Ibn Abbas said about the ayah, قل لا أسألكم عليه أجرا إلا المودة في القربة. He said, Ibn Abbas, about this ayah, every single tribe of Quraysh, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم has a relation with it. You know, there are different tribes in Quraysh. Okay? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has a relation. Maybe from the third father, maybe from the fifth father, maybe from the tenth father, there is a relation. There is a relationship between the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Abu Bakr. Where? Maybe in the fourth father. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Muhammad and Umar. Where? Maybe in the sixth one. So every single tribe, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has a relation. Alayhi salatu wassalam. طيب, there is a very important point, which is that, if you remember, we mentioned that the parents of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam were not Muslims. طيب, so what about the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Is it a correct family? I mean, the relationship between Abdullah and Amina, the parents of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was it a correct relationship? Or it was, a'udhu billah, يعني, adultery? No. It was, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came from pure relationship, from a valid marriage. He said, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kharajtu min nikah wa lam akhruj min sifah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I came from authentic marriage. I did not come from adultery. Because in Mecca, before Islam, there was adultery. They don't care. Many of them don't care. Yes, some of them, yes, but also many of them don't care about marriage. They do adultery or they do marriage. The Prophet ﷺ clarified this and he said, I came from marriage, not from adultery. So my father, Abdullah, married my mother, Amina, by authentic marriage. It means my father, Abdullah, went to the mother, the father of my mother. Like our marriage now. Like if you want to marry, you should go to the father of that girl. So the same thing happened to the parents of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What about the grandfather of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the grandfather of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said all of them came from marriage, not adultery. He said, I came from marriage, not from adultery. From Adam until my father. So the Prophet ﷺ closed the doors. If anyone tries to accuse the Prophet ﷺ, we tell him, the door is closed. And all the fathers of Rasulullah ﷺ and all the mothers came from authentic and valid marriage, not adultery. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected the lineage, the family, the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, and then at the end of the hadith, he said, وَلَمْ يُصِبْنِي مِنْ سِفَاحِ الْجَاهِلِيَةِ شَيْءٍ. None of the adultery of the jahiliyyah, the pre-Islamic period, none of it came to me. So the whole lineage of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is pure, clean. And also all the prophets, alayhim salatu wassalam, they came from authentic marriage, and also they did authentic marriage with their wives, alayhim salatu wassalam. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I came in the best century. Okay? So Allah chose the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam from the best century, alayhi salatu wassalam. And also, hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, Allah chose from the children of Ibrahim the best. يعني, this hadith is a proof that Ismail is better than Ishaq. All of them are best, alayhim salatu wasalam. All the prophets are perfect. But from this hadith, it tells us that Ismail is better than Ishaq. So he said, I came from the best of children of Ibrahim. And Allah has chosen Kinana is a name of a tribe. Kinana from Ismail. Okay? And Allah has chosen Quraysh from Kinana. And Allah has chosen Hashim from Quraysh. And Allah has chosen me from Hashim. So the Prophet ﷺ, best from the best. Alayhi salatu wassalam. One day the Prophet ﷺ stood up on the minbar. Okay? Then he asked the people, who am I? Man ana? Who am I? Then people said, You are the messenger of Allah. You are the messenger of Allah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I am Muhammad, the son of Abdullah, the son of Abdul Muttalib. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the creatures, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah put me in the best creatures. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made them two groups, Allah put them in the best, put me in the best group. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the tribes, Allah put me in the best tribe. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the homes, Allah put me in the best home. So my home is the best. And I am the best soul, alayhi salatu wasalam. So he's from the best tribe, from the best family, from the best home, and he's the best man, alayhi salatu wasalam. And he said in the authentic hadith, ana sayyid walad Adam, I am the leader of the children of Adam. Okay, the Prophet ﷺ said this because he was arrogant? No. Then he said, wala fakhr. I am the leader of the children of Adam. I am the leader of the children of Adam. And I'm not arrogant. I'm not boasting. I'm not proud of my family or of my name. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, we mentioned the birth of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we mentioned hadith that he was born in the year of al-fil, the elephant. And we mentioned the story of the elephant when they came from Yemen to Mecca. In which day specifically? On Monday. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born on Monday. But which Monday? We are not sure. And this is not important. In the 9th of Rabi'ul Awwal, the 8th, 12, we are not sure. Why? Because we don't have a proof hadith. We don't have an authentic proof. We don't have authentic evidence. Tayyib, and the scholars mentioned, some of them said the 9th of Rabi' al-Awwal, some of them said the 12th, some of them said maybe Ramadan. Allahu alam, we are not sure. We are not sure. We are sure about Monday. He was born on Monday, alayhi salatu wassalam. When he was born, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned hadith that my mother saw a dream. It is like light came from me, his mother said. I saw a dream that when I gave birth, I saw a light. And she was in Mecca, and the light reached to Sham, Syria. Alayhi salatu wassalam. What happened when the Prophet ﷺ was born? Hassan ibn Thabit, radiyallahu ta'ala, he's older than the Prophet ﷺ, maybe in a few years, 7 years, something like this. He said, when I was a boy, alayhi salatu wassalam, less than puberty, 10 years old, 7, 8, 11, something like this. He said, when I was a boy, say about 7, 8 years, I was realizing what is happening. Like now, the students, grade 1, they are 7 years old. Grade 2, 8 years old. They have perception. They can do their homework. So he said, I was 7, 8 years old. I heard a Jewish man shouting in Medina. What was the old name of Medina? Yathrib. Yes, Yathrib. Yathrib is the old name of Medina. Okay, and this name came one time in the Quran. Ya ahla Yathrib la muqama lakum. This name came in the Quran, Yathrib. Okay, but now the name is Medina, or what is the other name of Medina? Taiba. Taiba. Taiba or Taba. Taiba or Taba. Okay. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this in hadith, authentic hadith, when he mentioned the Messiah al-Dajjal, the liar, the Messiah. He said, he will go through the earth, but he will not enter Taiba. He will not enter this place. The Prophet was in Medina. The Dajjal will not enter Taiba, will not enter Medina, and also he will not enter Mecca. He will try to enter, but the angels protecting Mecca and Medina, when he tries to enter, the angels will stop him. He will go to Taif, to Tabuk, Kuwait, Iraq, south, everywhere, except Mecca and Medina. So Hassan Thabit said, I was young, and when I was in Medina, I heard a Jewish man shouting, saying, what? Ya ma'shara Yahud, O Jewish people. So they came. Then said, what is happening? Why you are calling us? He said, طَلَعَ اللَّيْلَ نَجْمُ أَحْمَدَ الَّذِي وُلِدَ بِهِ. Today, I saw the star that means that Muhammad is born, alayhi salatu wassalam. طيب. So subhanAllah, if you notice, the Yahud, the Jewish people know who is Muhammad. Okay, and they know his description, his criteria, but they did not follow him. There are a lot of Christians, subhanAllah, Christians people are softer than the Jewish people. And now we notice, subhanAllah, many Christian people accepted Islam. Every day we hear, sah? And for example, here in Ramadan, every day maybe 3, 4, 10 people accept Islam. And many of them Christians. But how many Jewish people accept Islam? SubhanAllah, how many Jewish people? They are very difficult. And that, subhanAllah, the most hated people to the Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لو آمن بي عشرة من اليهود لآمنت بي يهود. If 10 Jewish people believe in me, then the whole Jewish people will become Muslim. Some scholars said the meaning of the hadith, if only 10 leaders of the Jews believe in me, then the whole of them will believe in me. But the Prophet knows that they are very difficult people. And they have knowledge. They are worse than the Christians. But and why they say it? Because they have knowledge. They know that this is Muhammad, and this is Quran, and this is Islam, the religion of Allah. But they don't accept. Why? Arrogance. Because of jealousy. SubhanAllah, because of envy toward the Muslims. SubhanAllah. When the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam born, Tayyib, who took care? Because يعني, it was common that not the mother sometimes takes care of the baby. Someone else. طيب. Let's see this hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. Habiba bint Abi Sufyan. Who is Habiba? Who is Habiba? Yes. What is the relation with the Prophet ﷺ? Relationship? Wife. Habiba, she is our mother. She is one of our mothers. Please, brothers and sisters, you should know who is your mother. Aisha is your mother. Habiba. Zainab bin Jahsh. Zainab bin Khuzaima. Salama. All of them, our mothers. So Habiba, her name is Ramla bint Abi Sufyan, the sister of Muawiyah ibn Sufyan, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum ajma'in. She said, O Rasulullah, do and marry my sister. Now, Habiba, she is the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she told her husband, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, please, O Rasulullah, marry my sister. Her name is Azza. O Rasulullah, marry my sister Azza. This is very strange. This is very strange. Imagine that your wife tells you, go and marry my sister. This is impossible. صح? She will kill you. طيب. Okay, why? Why Habiba said to the Prophet ﷺ to marry my sister? She said, the Prophet ﷺ said, do you like this? Do you like that I marry your sister? This is a strange request. She said, yes, I like this. Why? She clarified why. She said, O Rasulullah, because I am not the only wife. You have, mashallah, several wives. So if you are marrying women, so marry my wife, my sister. Then she will be your wife in dunya and the akhirah. Good concept, huh? Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, no, this is not allowed for me. This is not allowed for me. In Islam, it is not allowed to marry the woman and her sister. To join two sisters as wives, this is not allowed in Islam. But for example, if you divorce one, then you go and marry her sister, this is allowed. Or if one of them passed away and you go and marry the second, this is allowed. But you join both of them, this is not allowed. طيب. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, no, this is not allowed for me. This is not allowed for me. Then Habiba said, then, O Rasulullah, we are talking that you like to marry the daughter of Salama. Again, who is Salama? Salama also his wife. Salama also the wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Habiba said, okay, so why you want to go to marry the daughter of Salama? You want to marry, you are married to Salama, and also you are going to marry her daughter. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the daughter of Salama? Who said that I'm going to marry? Subhanallah, even at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there were rumors. People talking, true, false. Subhanallah. Not only now, also now people talk a lot. But we don't know, right, wrong, we don't know. Also at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, many people or some of the companions talk without proofs. So she said, because we are talking that you are going to marry the daughter from Salama. The Prophet ﷺ said, the daughter from Salama? I'm going to marry the daughter from Salama? My Salama is my wife. The Prophet ﷺ said, no, this is not, yani, it is not allowed. Why? Because the daughter of Salama, okay, yani, Rabibati fi Hijri. Rabiba, it is like, yani, I raised her. So it is not allowed. Yani now, if you go and marry a woman, and this woman has daughter, if you marry this woman, it is not allowed for you to marry the daughter of this woman. So the Prophet ﷺ said, it is not allowed to marry the daughter of Salama. It is not allowed. And also, she is the daughter of my brother. She is the daughter of my brother. Me and her father, it means Abu Salama, both of us were breastfed by Thuwaybah. So one of the women who breastfeed the Prophet ﷺ is Thuwaybah. If you remember, we mentioned Halima al-Sa'diyya. She's also the mother of Rasulullah ﷺ, breastfed him, and also Thuwaybah. Also Thuwaybah. And subhanAllah, Thuwaybah was a slave of Abu Lahab. Thuwaybah was a slave of Abu Lahab. Also, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned a hadith. Okay, when yani, some of the companions said, oh Rasulullah, please tell us about you, yourself. Tell us some stories about you. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, I am the dua of Ibrahim. And I am the glad tiding of Isa. I am the dua of Ibrahim. What does it mean? I am dua of Ibrahim. Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam made a dua. Rabbana wabathim rasulam minhum. Ibrahim made a dua. He asked Allah, oh Allah, send a messenger from among them. It means people of Mecca, Arab. So Allah answered the dua of Ibrahim, and he sent Muhammad as a messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. And I am the glad tiding of Isa, of Jesus. As we mentioned, وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ أَحْمَدٍ. So I am the glad tiding from Isa, alayhi salatu wasalam. And also, my mother saw a light from Mecca to Sham. Sham, it is the Syria area, Syria, Jordan, Palestine. وَاسْتُرْضِعْتُ فِي بَدِي سَعْدِ بْنِي بَكْرِ. And breastfeeding was in the tribe of Bani Sa'd. He means, alayhi salatu wasalam, he means Halim al-Sa'diyya. He means Halim al-Sa'diyya. Then the Prophet started to mention the hadith that we mentioned last week. I was with my brother. Both of us, we get the milk from Halim al-Sa'diyya. So he is my brother, breastfeeding. He mentioned when the two angels came and they put the Prophet on the ground and they opened. They did the surgery. And we mentioned the hadith, they opened the stomach and they took his heart out. Then they took a small piece, black piece or something. They said, this is from the shaitan, and they throw it outside. Then they cleaned the heart of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. With which water? Zamzam water. Then they put the heart inside and they closed the chest and stomach. So the Prophet sallam pure from outside and inside. Alayhi salatu wasalam. Okay, and also in this hadith, these two angels, one of them said, put him in a balance. So put him in one side and put 1,000 of his nation on the other side. Then the Prophet ﷺ won this balance. Then the angel said, put more. He said, if I put all of his followers, the whole nation, the Prophet ﷺ will be heavier than them. It means he is the best sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And subhanAllah, this incident, the opening of the heart of the chest of Rasulullah ﷺ, happened two times. One time when he was a boy, he was a shepherd sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay? They asked him, O Rasulullah, did you work as a shepherd? He said, all the prophets worked as shepherd, even me. Ala qadarit min ahli Makkah. I was a shepherd and I was getting very little money from it. All the prophets, alayhim salatu wasalam. Tayyib. So they said, this happened two times, the opening of the stomach of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his chest, cleaning of his heart. One time when he was a boy, maybe 6 years old, 4 years old, something like this. And the other time, when? Isra al-Mi'raj. Isra al-Mi'raj, yani about 1 year or 3 years before the migration from Mecca to Medina. From Mecca to Medina, alayhi salatu wassalam. Also, yani, last thing today, that the Prophet is a blessed man. He is a blessed man, alayhi salatu wasalam. The blessing from Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one of his blessings, his mother, as we said, Halim al-Sa'diyya, because she breastfed him. Halim al-Sa'diyya. From which tribe? Hawazin. Okay? Later, after maybe 50 years or 55 years, there was a war between the Muslims and Hawazin. Hawazin is the tribe of Halim al-Sa'diyya. So the Prophet ﷺ, the Muslim army won the battle. They defeated the Kuffar, Hawazin. And they took their money and also they took the women as slaves and the children. Tayyib. Then subhanAllah, they followed the Prophet ﷺ, the rest of this tribe, Hawazin. And they became Muslims. They accepted Islam. Then they said, O Rasulullah, we are your family. We are your family. What do they mean? They mean we are from your mother's side, Halim al-Sa'diyya. We are the tribe of Halima Sa'diyah. Halima Sa'diyah is your mother. And, oh Rasulullah, you took your money, you took our money, and you took the slaves, our children, our women, after the war. So please free the slaves and release our money. Then the Prophet ﷺ gave a khutbah. He gave a talk. He said, they asked him, the Prophet ﷺ said, Khalas, all what I have and also all what my family have is free. And I release your money to you again. Then the Ansar said, even us, O Rasulullah, we will follow you. We will release the money and we will free the slaves. Because this is your family. So subhanAllah, this is the blessing of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah saved the whole tribe because of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'll stop here inshallah. Continue next week. Zakum Allah khair. Wa salli Allah sallam ala Muhammad.